Hello everyone, my name is Danny from creatingawebstore.com, and in today's tutorial I'm going to show you how to remove the background of an image, or actually how to erase the background of an image. Now, as someone that has a store, I actually have to do this quite often because when I'm taking pictures of items, I have to remove the background of the item so that it looks a little more presentable. So to start, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to open up your image. And if the image is locked, you're going to want to unlock it by simply double-clicking on the layer and clicking OK, as you can see. And then you're going to want to create a new layer by clicking left-clicking on this icon here. And now what we're going to do is we're going to move this empty layer beneath our actual image. And what we're going to do is we're going to fill this layer with a color, so that we can see what we're actually doing, because on a transparent background it's a little harder to see. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go with a pretty bright color. And then remember to again select the layer that you're actually going to be editing. And now what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go on the eraser tool, and you're going to want to right click on it, and you're going to want to left click on background eraser tool. And then you're going to want to select the brush size. This is up to you. Select whatever you would feel most comfortable with. And then you're going to want to go right here where it says sampling once. So you're going to want to make sure that the second option is chosen. And then you're going to want to choose continuous for limits and for tolerance. What you basically want to do is you want to edit this tolerance to whatever level you feel is needed. For example, if you have an image that has a very light foreground color and a very light background color, you're going to want to go lower in tolerance. And if you have an image that, for example, where the foreground can be easily distinguished from the background, then you can go higher in tolerance. And as for protect foreground color, you're going to want to leave this unchecked. So once we have all this set, we can begin. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the light areas. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go lower in tolerance. And then you just simply left click, and you just basically drag and erase. And this is all that's needed. And now we can move on to other parts of the image. Now we're ready to clean up this area. Keep in mind that since this is a gradient background, it's a little more difficult to deal with, and that's why I have to keep going back and forth with the tolerance levels and all of this. Now if this was a solid background, I would have probably already been finished by now. But since it's not, it's going to take longer, and I'm actually going to fast forward this video during certain parts, and during the important parts I'll slow down. What I'll basically be doing is I'll be moving the tolerance level up and down, and I'll be switching the size of the brush, and I will also be dragging and also clicking at times when necessary, and I'm also going to be using the regular eraser tool when necessary. For example, right now I'm going to use the regular eraser tool to clean up around the model. Because it would make no sense to use the background eraser tool, since that would just take forever. So I'm going to try to do a very good job, and that's why it's going to take longer. Of course, if you're not really worried about the details, you don't really have to go through all this. I want to make it look as good as possible, so I'm going to take a while. Now I'm just going to use a smaller brush, because if not I would just wipe everything off. And that's that. So now we have a nice, beautiful, transparent background. And this is actually a male model that I cleaned up earlier. And as you can see, we can add this model to the background. And the image just looks amazing. And we can also grab this tunnel and put it behind them, and everything in my opinion looks great. I mean, sure, we can do a little bit of a cleanup over here, so that's that. Again, it all depends on how good of a job you want to do. I mean, you can get this to look perfect if you really want it to. You can spend an hour on it with a very low tolerance level just to make sure that it's perfect, but to me this looks great. So thanks for watching, stay tuned for more videos, and also be sure to check out creatingawebstore.com.